According to recent market research, the surface treatment anodization has become the most popular surface treatment to aluminum parts. That's because anodization can protect aluminum very well. Thanks to the anodization process, aluminum's corrosion resistance increases and the material can retain its appearance for longer. Let's understand the anodizing process better, shall we? Oxidation is a very common chemical reaction process in nature. The artificial anodizing uses the metal part as the anode. Using electrolytic process, a layer of hard metal oxide is formed at an anode. If you're interested in more details during the process, please click this video to see our another video. So the aim of anodizing surface treatment is that oxide layer created during the process can protect aluminum from being further oxidized. Sometimes there will be other requirements for some reasons for the anodization process. Some parts with critical threads and holes cannot be entirely anodized, and the important thread holes must be prevented from being anodized. The reason behind this requirement is very easy to understand. Anodization is a process to add an extra layer of hard metal oxide. It will cause influences on the tolerance such as the diameters. For high precision parts, this is not acceptable. It's very common for us, and our regular solution for prototype is to use tape to mask the critical threads. If the customers agree, we tape after anodization process for batch production. To choose the better solution depends on part structure and design. Thread holes are small surfaces to mask. However, for some reasons, sometimes there will be bigger surfaces to avoid anodization during the machining. For instance, this is a mating part to an effector. This part requires to mask the whole internal cylinder, fillet, and adjacent surfaces. The reason about that is to maintain electric conduction. Anodized layer also influences electric conduction. So in order to keep perfect conductivity, bigger surface shall be prevented from being anodized. What solutions do we have? There are different methods we can think about. Number one, anodize first and machine the feature after. Before the certain features are machined, we can proceed anodization first and then machine the feature so that the anodized coating will be removed in the process. However, this method may have some negative impacts on tolerances. So we have number two. Like how we do the thread holes, we can use tape to mask the surface as well. But this method is not very suitable for volume production because taping needs manpower. Number three, laser engraving can remove the layer as well. For volume production, it's good to use laser engraving when the entire part is being anodized to remove the extra coating. However, this method is limited by the part structure. Anodizing can break resistance to the surface. It also brings better appearance. Matte and gloss anodizing are two options that designers likely will go for. Matte surface can be achieved by adding sandblasting, and gloss results need fine machining and excellent roughness before anodizing. If our video resonated with you a little, please share and follow us. We'll see you next time.